you don't have. Oh, yours is my home. You will do this? Okay. That is good. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله على النبي الكريم محمد وآله وأصحابه أجمعين. As we were talking about أسباب الوضع are the reason for fake hadith. Why people fabricated a hadith and attributed it to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. So another reason for this is that people, they were prejudicial towards each other. Either on racist basis or country basis or on the basis of madhab. Some people from Jordan who had a prejudice towards the people of Syria, who had a prejudice towards the people of Syria, so they fabricated a hadith. إِذَا ذَهَبَ الْإِيمَانُ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ وُجِدَ بِبَطْنِ الْأُرْضُنِ وَالْجُفَاءُ وَالْبَغْيُ فِي الشَّامِ. So they said, when Iman is not found anywhere, so that will be there in Jordan. When Iman is not found anywhere, that will be there in Jordan. Rebellious action and cruelty will happen in Syria. So somebody had some prejudice towards a person of Syria or a group of Syria, so he fabricated this hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that when Iman is not found anywhere, that will be there in Jordan. Yes, and brutality and hardship will be there in Syria. So this is a fabrication based upon what? Prejudice. Or a Persian one, he was prejudiced towards Arabs. So he fabricated a hadith and he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ إِذَا غَضِبَ أَنزَلَ الْوَحْيَ بِالْعَرَبِيَّةِ وَإِذَا رَضِيَ أَنزَلَ الْوَحْيَ بِالْفَارِسِيَّةِ. That when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is happy, he sends wahy in Arabic, he sends wahy in Persian language. And when he is unhappy or angry, then he sends the same in Arabic. Try this. Or someone follower of Abu Hanifa, rahimahullah, he became angry with the Shafi. He became angry with someone who was follower of Shafi, rahmatullahi alayh. So he said that An-Nu'man huwa siraj ummati. That Abu Hanifa, he is the lamp and light of my ummah. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said so and so. So because of mazhabi prejudice, he fabricated the saying and attributed the same to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Got it? Fake. What? Fake. You wrote it? Another, there was a alim and he was blind. He was in need of some guide. He was in need of some guide and nobody was helping him. So he fabricated a hadith that man qada a'ma 40 khutwatan wajabat lahu al-jannah. Whosoever will guide a blind one 40 steps, certainly he will go to Jannah. You know what I'm saying? So by saying so, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said so and so. You wrote it? So that was fabricated by one guy, Muhammad ibn Abdul Malik al-Ama. Muhammad ibn Abdul Malik al-Ama, the blind. Another guy, his name is Sa'id ibn Tarif. Sa'id ibn Tarif. His son came crying from his teacher. What is that? Yes. Son came crying. The father asked him, why you are crying? So he said, the teacher beat me. The teacher? Yes. Got it? So he said, Wallahi la ukhzijannahum. I swear by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I will put these teachers down and I will humiliate them. So he fabricated a saying that Haddathani Hikramah Han ibn Abbas, that this hadith, Hikramah told me, he relayed from Ibn Abbas that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Muallimu Sibyanikum Shirarukum Rahmatan Akalluhum Rahmatan Lil Yateem Wa Aghlazuhum Halal Miskeen, that the worst people in my ummah, they are the teachers of your small kids. That Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, that the worst people in my ummah, they are the teachers of your small kids. They do not have any kindness toward an orphan. This is right here. But don't use it against them. Yes. They do not show kindness toward an orphan. And they are very hard and harsh towards the poor one. So that was a fabrication. And as we mentioned before, that this practice basically is started by whom? By Shias. Hafiz ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayh, he said that regarding virtues of the family of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, regarding the virtues of the family of Muhammad, nobody knows how many fake hadiths, the Shia sects, they have fabricated. You should write it. Ibn Taymiyyah said that nobody knows how many fake hadiths they have fabricated. And he said that to counter them, the ignorant Sunnis, they put some fake hadith in the virtues of Abu Bakr and Umar, Uthman and Muawiyah. They put some fake hadith in the virtues of Abu Bakr, Umar, Uthman and Muawiyah. Rizwanullahi alayhim ajma'in. Shariq ibn Abdullah, a critic in hadith, who? Shariq ibn Abdullah, he says that Ahmadu an kulli man laqeed illa al-rafida. I take hadith from everyone except Shia. Shariq ibn Abdullah, he is authentic scholar. He says, I take hadith from everyone except Shia. فَإِنَّهُ يَذَهُونَ الْحَدِيثِ وَيَتَّخِذُونَهُ دِينًا. Because they make fake a hadith and they take it as deen. Hammad ibn Salama, Hammad ibn Salama, he is another scholar. He said that a scholar from Shia, when he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he was crying and he used to say that whenever we gather together, whenever we the Shias gather together, فَاسْتَحْسَنَّا شَيْئًا جَهَلْنَا وَحَدِيثًا, and we thought about something that is good, so we decided, let's make a hadith. And the second one, Khawarij. Who? Khawarij. Because they are Kharij Hantawa, out of the obedience of anybody. They were not subjecting their son neither to Muawiyah nor to Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. That's why they are called Khawarij. And they think of themselves only Muslims, and all other people, they are kafir regarding to them. Those who are not with them, you should write it. Those who are not with them are on their belief. So they say all of them, they are kafir. Even though their basic belief is that whosoever committed a sin, he is a kafir. He lost his iman. He lost his iman. So they are not telling lies. They try to avoid lies. But regarding their own facts, they fabricate. Regarding their own beliefs, they fabricate. Ibn Lahiha, a well-known scholar of ilm hadith. Ibn Lahiha, he says, سمعت شيخا من الخوارج تاب ورجع وهو يقول إن هذه الأحاديث دين فانظروا عمن تأخذون دينكم فإنا كنا إذا هبنا أمرا سيرناه حديثا. I saw a sheikh of Khawarij. He repented. And he used to tell people that this knowledge is deen. This knowledge is deen. So you must think about your sheikh. Whom from you are taking a hadith? Because we the Khawarij, he said, because we the Khawarij, whenever we desired something, we made a hadith. Mukhtar ibn Abi Ubaid al-Thaqafi, this was a guy, he was with Bani Umayyah, with whom? But what he wanted to be, when he couldn't proceed, so he came to Makkah to Abdullah ibn Zubayr. To whom? That maybe he will put him in the front row. Maybe. Because ibn Zubayr, radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he himself declared himself Khalifa in Makkah. Yes? So Mukhtar ibn Abi Ubaid al-Thaqafi, he came to ibn Zubayr to have a place there in the front row with the Khalifa. To be a minister. But when he couldn't get into, so then he went. You should write it. Then he went back to Kufa. And he fought against Bani Umayyah. And he killed the killer of Hussein radiallahu ta'ala ghan, Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad. Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad. You know what I'm saying? So anyhow, this Mukhtar ibn Abi Ubaid al-Saqafi, he said to one alim and one scholar, to write it. That can you please make in my favor a hadith or a few hadith? That Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَنِّي كَائِنٌ بَعْدَهُ خَلِيفَةٌ وَطَالِبٌ لَهُ بِدْرَةَ وَلَدِهِ. This, I will be a khalifa after Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then you can put either my qualities or my name, that Mukhtar ibn Abi Ubaid will be a khalifa after me. And he will take the revenge of my son, Hussein. Got it? And he told him that I will give you a ride, Mercedes Benz. I will give you a servant, duly paid by me. Yes? I will give you 10,000 dirham in cash. And every year I will be giving you all of your needs and necessities. Should write this. So that alim was also a funny man. He said to him, Amma an Rasulillah fala. As far as the case of the Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is concerned, I cannot attribute anything lie to him. I can't do that. Yes. Wa amma man dunahu fa in shayta afaluhu wa akhudtuka min as-saman. If you want me to fabricate something to attribute it to one of the Sahaba of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I will do that. Yes, you can give me instead of 10,000, 5,000. Yes, but regarding Rasulullah, I can't do that. Should write it. Note, for fake hadith, Iraq was the capital and the center. And it was called as Darul Darb. What? Darul Darb. In Pakistan, they call it where they are making the coins, they call it Taksal. Yes? Where they are making the money. That they call, I don't know what they call it here. The first one. The first one, this guy. Yes. Got it? So that's called Darul Darb. Darul Darb is a place where the bills are printed. This is like where the currency is printed. Where? The currency is printed. So Iraq was called Darul Darb. Currency was not printed there. A hadith was printed there. You should write it. Say a hadith was printed there. The next topic is how the ulama and the scholars, they countered this fitna. How they countered this fitna. Zindiq is one who was making fake hadith. Zindiq. What? Zindiq is one who pretends that he is a Muslim. But actually, he is a conspirator in Islam. He is trying to confuse people in their deen. So he is called Zindiq. So a Zindiq who made almost 4,000 fake hadith. So he was brought to Khalifa Harun al-Rashid. He was from Banu Abbas and he was a student of Imam Malik. His two sons, Amin and Mamun, both they were the students of Imam Malik as well. Father and sons, all of them, they were the students of Imam Malik, rahimahullah. So he was brought to Khalifa Harun Rashid. So Harun Rashid said that this is such a crime, the guy concerned may not be pardoned or forgiven. Should write it. So he ordered his execution. So he said to Khalifa Harun that you will kill me, but what you will do with the 4,000 fake hadith I have mingled and mixed with the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Write it. So Harun told him, you do not know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken the responsibility to protect both thoughts and both kinds of wahi. إِنَّا نَحْنَ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. So he said that we have Abdullah ibn Mubarak, who say Abdullah ibn al-Mubarak, who is called as Amir al-Mu'mineen fil hadith, and Abu Ishaq al-Fazari, Abu Ishaq al-Fazari. Harun told him that we have Abu Ishaq al-Fazari and Abdullah ibn Mubarak. They will sort out all these fake hadiths and throw it away. And then Harun brought them both. And he ordered the guy, just start. So he was mixing. For example, one genuine hadith, two fake. Two genuine hadith, one fake. Got it? Got it or not? And Abu Ishaq al-Fazari and Ibn Mubarak, they were marking every single hadith. Yes. And without counting, they threw it to the guy. Now you should find out. Now you should. He counted. All 4,000 hadith which were fake, Abu Ishaq and Abdullah ibn Mubarak, put them aside. Said, that is your stuff. This is a bakwas. And these are the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The guy was killed, but in his last moment he said that of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect this deen from any type of tahreef and perversion. Wa sallallahu ta'ala ala khayri khalqihi Muhammadin wa alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in.